The story of the Guardians of David is a story of our world. In a region historically prized for its strategic military and economic value, known today as Israel and Palestine. These lands were once called Canaan. 4 millennia ago, Abraham was called by God to move to Canaan, where he had 2 sons. Abraham's second son, Isaac, had a son, Jacob, who later became known as Israel. Years later, terrible famine forced Israel's descendants to Egypt. 430 years later, Moses led the Israelites from Egypt to Canaan, where Joshua and the Israelites claimed the land and allocated it among their 12 tribes. It is now 400 years later, and enemies press in from all sides. The Israelites pray for a king to lead them into battle. From their prayers emerges Saul, anointed by the prophet Samuel to be king over the 12 tribes of Israel. Though King Saul follows God for a time, his disobedience and mistrust cause God to reject Saul as king. In secret, Samuel anoints the shepherd boy David as the future king, although David will not become king for many more years. Saul and his army gather for battle against the Philistine army. However, neither army is aware of 2 shepherd boys on a nearby hillside who will become Israel's guardian warriors.
The young shepherds Abishai and Benaiah awakened late after a night filled with the sounds and smells of the nearby Philistine army. Their camp overlooked the valley of Elah below. The shepherds had faith that King Saul would soon defeat the invading Philistines.
Good morning, Benaiah.
Morning, Abishai.
Oh no, the sheep has been killed.
It was one of the old shepherds' flock. We need to tell him.
Begins on a hillside overlooking the Valley of Elah. This valley was the location of the Battle of David and Goliath. Today it is a popular tourist destination.
Thank you.
We found one of your sheep up by our camp. It was eaten by wolves.
We came as fast as we could.
Calm down, boys. I saw the wolves yesterday and, well, I was afraid something like this might happen. I will handle them.
On the way here, we came across some of them.
We took care of them. We'll help you get rid of the rest.
Oh, thank you, boys, but I think it will be best for the two of you to return to Abishai's mother. She has been looking for you, huh? Something about chores?
Abishai is described as one of David's mighty... warriors. The Bible does not talk about his childhood.
Well, good morning, boys.
Good morning, Mother.
I've been waiting for you, Abishai. The sheep have been waiting for you, too. You know you were supposed to take them out at first light.
I'm sorry, Mother. We ran into some problems.
We had to talk to the old shepherd. We found one of his sheep.
I'm sure it is all very exciting, but you have responsibilities. I had to send your sister Ariella out with the flock this morning, and she is waiting for you. Please go and send her back to me. She has chores of her own.
Yes, Mother.
Benaiah is described as David's toughest warrior. The Bible does not talk about his childhood.
On their way to find Ariella, the boys heard the sounds of a struggle and came upon the old shepherd in a fight for his life with three Philistine soldiers.
I guess I'm not as young as I used to be,
Are you okay?
Oh, I'm fine. Don't you worry about me. There are other soldiers raiding your father's stores, Abishai.
What do we do?
We must stop them, of course. I will not be able to do it alone. I will need your help, but on one condition. That you never tell Abishai's mother.
Several times in the Bible as being killers of sheep.
My sister Ariella? She was supposed to be with the flock.
Your flock was in its pen when I came across the soldiers. She heard them coming and ran off somewhere to hide, huh? I doubt she went very far.
Can't do that.
Sister of David, and her three sons were Abishai, Joab, and Azahel. So Abishai was David's nephew. Since David was a shepherd, it is possible that Abishai was too.
Yeah.
was located in the lands owned by the tribe of Judah. Jesus was called the Lion of Judah. Bible about Zariah having daughters. The character of Ariella was created to improve the story of Five. Lions are referenced several times in the Bible. They were a common wild animal in Israel at the time of David. David killed at least one lion. Down in a pit on a snowy day and killed a lion. The Bible does not say how, when, or where he did this.
In a pit carved out of the floor of the cave, they came upon Abishai's sister. She was pushing and pulling at a large rock that had rolled on her. Not far from her was a large and menacing lion.
Abishai, help! I'm stuck!
Abishai, go to her and help her get free.
But the lion!
I will keep the lion busy. Now go!
Can't do that.
You killed it! Ben just saved your life. You need to stop being so reckless. Now go straight home, Ariella. Mother is worried sick about you. I can't believe you killed that lion, Ben. I thought we were all dead. My Uncle David killed a lion once. And a bear.
The next day.
And that's why arranging themselves on the slopes of Wadi El-Gindi is best. The Philistines must cross not one, not two, but three streams before even attempting the ascent up the slope. Hey, that's my Uncle David! David! Where are you headed, Uncle?
I'm bringing food to my brothers serving in King Saul's army. Here, you two can help me carry it to them. It's not much further.
Today I defy Israel and your God. Send out a man and let us fight.
Why does Saul allow that man to blaspheme God?
Is your uncle really going to ask King Saul to accept the giant's challenge?
My men are saying that you want to fight the Philistine giant.
Yes.
Here, take my armor. You will need it.
I do not need your armor. God will protect me.
David picked up 5 smooth stones on his way to meet the giant Goliath. King Saul and the Israelite army had assembled in the Valley of Elah. They pitched camp near Ephes Demim, between Sukkot and Azekah. The Philistines occupied one hill and the Israelites another, with the valley between them. Among the enemy soldiers, none was more terrifying than the champion from Gath, a giant Philistine named Goliath. He stood over 9 feet tall and wore a bronze helmet on his head and wore a coat of scale armor of bronze. On his legs, he wore bronze greaves, and a bronze javelin was slung on his back. His spear shaft was like a weaver's rod, and its iron point weighed 15 pounds alone. His shield bearer went ahead of him. In King Saul's camp, Abishai and Benaiah found David exiting the king's tent.
David!
You're not gonna fight that Philistine, are you?
I am. The Lord is with me and I will win.
David, wait!
You come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied.
I ask for a man, and you send me a boy. Am I a dog that you come at me with a puny stick? Come here and meet your fate, little Israelite.
This day I will give the carcasses of the Philistine army to the birds and wild animals, and the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel.
David takes Goliath's own sword to deliver the killing blow. The Philistines ran when they saw that their champion was defeated. The men of Israel and Judah surged forward with a shout and pursued the Philistines all the way to the entrance of Gath.
That was amazing!
You did it! I can't believe you won!
The Lord delivered Israel a great victory today. I need you to go out into the Philistine camps and gather up all of the iron weapons and armor that you can. Keep what you find somewhere safe.
I know a cave that'll make a good hiding spot.
During the time of David, the main two people groups contesting land in Israel were the Philistines and Israelites. The Israelites tried to occupy their tribal lands as previously allocated by Joshua. the armies of the Israelites and Philistines were in a stalemate condition for at least 40 days before David arrived. Took a staff and sling to fight Goliath. Apparently, he meant to use the staff as a weapon. Goliath wore a helmet. However, David's stone sank into Goliath's forehead. How did that happen?
Many years have passed since David killed Goliath. David has become a fine military commander of King Saul. Abishai and Benaiah are now mighty warriors serving under David. They are becoming his trusted advisors. Abishai's younger brother, Joab, is a brilliant strategist that David often relies on for critical military planning. David commands 1,000 men and his exploits have earned him acclaim throughout Israel. King Saul has long battled the Philistines, and the people sing his praises. But he has been in a foul mood lately, since the people have begun shouting for...
David!
David is coming!
Saul has slain his thousands, and David his tens of thousands!
David will crush the Philistines!
Is that David?
He's so handsome!
Do you hear that, Ishbosheth?
Father, why do you let the people cheer for David? He is not the king. Why don't you get rid of him?
I've told you before, my son. I can't get rid of him.
Why not? You were anointed by God. You're the king. You can do whatever you want.
Yes, I am the king. I can do what I want. I am the king.
Going somewhere?
What are you doing? You know King Saul wants me arrested. Go home.
We are coming with you, Uncle.
No one is being arrested tonight. Killed, maybe, but not arrested.
That is my fear, Benaiah.
Oh, won't be any of us that dies. We're not letting anyone get near you tonight.
I cannot allow you to risk your lives for me.
Cannot allow? We have risked our lives for you countless times on the battlefield, as you have risked yours for us.
Like it or not, David, we are your men.
Thank you. But understand this, no killing. If we are discovered, so be it.
Whatever. Let's just not get caught.
Ariella, what are you doing here?
I am helping our uncle escape the madness of Saul. Why?
Cannot come with us. Go home.
Go home. Go home? I'm not 7 years old anymore, Abishai. You can't just send me home to mother.
You cannot come with us. It's too dangerous.
Why? Because I am a woman?
You are my sister, and I cannot allow anything to happen to you.
Yet you can risk your life for David. I have that right also. Plus, I am the only chance you three have of sneaking out of here alive.
She is quite sneaky.
Hush! We don't want to attract any attention.
Yes. We need to be quieter.
Can you actually get us out of the city unseen?
Easily. Saul's guards bumble around like drunken fools. You just need to let me clear the path for you. Follow behind me and only move when I say so.
Ariella, at the first sign of trouble, I want you gone. Do not attempt to fight. Just flee.
Of course, Uncle.
Lead on, my lady.
David was the captain over Saul's bodyguards at the time he escaped from Saul. Final incidents that caused David to leave, Saul had previously tried to kill David on at least two occasions. Once with a spear, and once by sending him to a hopeless battle.
Thank you.
Who's there?
You there! Halt!
Feared David for two reasons. Saul was probably going crazy, and he feared David would end his family's dynasty. David escaped from Saul with help from his wife, Michal, who was Saul's daughter. Saul had attained an ongoing intent to harm David. Headquarters and palace was at Gibeah. Excavations have uncovered a rustic fortress that many believe was Saul's palace. David lived in a house separate from the palace.
Stop! They're armed!
Is that David?
You'll not touch him.
Abishai, Benaiah, lower your weapons. We do not kill Israelites.
David, King Saul has ordered your arrest.
What?
Who are you?
My name is Eleazar. I am a soldier of Israel. My commander is David, son of Jesse.
Eleazar is described as one of the three, a special contingent of David's mighty warriors.
After escaping from King Saul, David, Abishai, and Benaiah fled into the wilderness south of Gibeah with their new friend, Eleazar. Ariella returned to stay with her mother. It was in a cave that the teens Abishai and Benaiah had stockpiled iron weapons taken from the Philistines, and where a young Benaiah had once slain a lion on a snowy day. The men could not agree on the exact location of the cave entrance. Abishai and Benaiah bickered relentlessly.
I know it's just around this corner, to the left. I remember that tree there.
You've been saying that for hours now. I'm telling you it's back the way we came. I will never forget the place I killed my first lion.
Please, you two. Can we just walk in silence for 5 minutes?